I would not be doing my job, right, if I did not teach the reality. So one thing that I often do is teach by the book, right? And then I say, now let me explain to you what happens in the real world. Because while the criminal justice system tries to be just, right, and has a lot of mechanisms in place to attempt to be just, the reality is that it often falls short. And it is my job as an instructor in showing my, in teaching my truth to expose my students to that.
I call it 180 degrees of knowledge, in that I try to have them look through the lens of everybody who would be involved in an incident. If there is a police incident, look through the lens of both the victim and the police officer and maybe the bystander. And then hopefully I can get the student to have a very well-rounded perspective on all of the parties involved in this. And I say justice from one perspective may not be justice from another perspective.
Students are coming to us a little more socially aware, right? Which is wonderful. It's absolutely wonderful. And it makes for such an engaging class.
And they're more, not only more aware, but more caring, more concerned about what's going on. But on the other side, I've also found out recently is that a lot of the students, they don't have a, there's no clear-cut plan as to how to address it.
Black Lives Matter movement is looking at things from a historical, social viewpoint. And a lot of times, students do not have knowledge of that history. So when they see an incident of police abuse of power against an unarmed person of color, they don't really understand the outrage that people of color may be experiencing from that image.
The energy that has come from this movement, this initiative, I think it has brought about another way of asking questions, a more critical, a way of critically thinking and saying these issues need to be addressed because they've gone on for so long.
I am the child of immigrants. So that puts me, you know, kind of in this, I have a unique perspective to, you know, to that, not only as a person of color, but as a person who comes from an immigrant background, you know, gives me a unique perspective on things. But I was always encouraged to pursue my passions.
There are times that I've had anxieties about my career, and that's just dealing with a lot of the systemic racism that's involved in our system, where there's a lot of different things that I've seen because I was in the inside. I could see that these things were applicable, but I wasn't in a position to change them.
While I have experienced some pushback professionally as a woman of color, right? It's for me, it's something that empowers me and makes me realize that we need more people that look like me, right? At the table, and our voices need to be heard.
This is a great field, but there's another side of this field. And the side of this field is that you are part of a process in which is going to make people captives. Right, wrong, or indifferent as to what they've done to be in that system. But the goal of the system is to create justice, and the end goal is to put people in jail. And so you are part of that process. And as a result of that, you have to have the mental capacity to be able to separate someone being locked away from the social injustices that may have gotten them locked away, because you have a job to do.
While the system strives to be just, it fails. It fails miserably sometimes. So we need a new generation of people who are not only aware of the deficiencies in the criminal justice system, aware of the implicit biases that exist in our society, but willing to do something about it. So if you're thinking about a career in criminal justice system, do it, do it, do it. You have a moral obligation to do it.